Well. Okay. It's time to continue. Okay. So, day two investigation. Yeah, everyone sure was obsessed with panties. Raised by a tribe of heathens. Nothing. I just started the game 2 minutes ago. Waka waka! Wocky pocky. Hey, do you want some panties? Guess not. No, I guess she's got nothing interesting to say. Thank you. Yeah, a killing. Well, there she goes. Wait. Don't worry, Mr. Dragon. Me and Hope haven't been on speaking terms for a while. That's a good line. We kill people, Bark. Apollo, please. See, I knew these slippers were gonna be important. No, it's past that. We're on investigation day two. He bribed her with money to make her go the long way around. Never speak of it again. Ew. That's disgusting.
So aren't we supposed to be going, like, inside the clinic itself? Oh, maybe I have to go to the detention center first. That's the one place I haven't gone. Oh boy. Yeah, Vice is back. Why not? We usually have to have some young woman as our sidekick. She brings magic tricks. Mr. Hat, and she also brings her panties. I'm not even sure if he's breathing. They're her magic panties, Zenith. She pulls stuff out of them. We've been over this. I mean, look, I've got two pairs of panties in my inventory. One of them magic, one of them belongs to a gangster. Make of that what you will. I must know the secret of your panties. Oh, Vice. I like when he's doing this animation, you can see his nose flare up just slightly. Okay, he's got nothing to really say. Well, that was illuminating. Okay, there we go. So we just needed to visit old Stickler first. We've been calling you the panty snatcher in this vice, because he reminds me of you.
Dropping frames. Okay, all better for now. Dr. Eldoon, huh? Onion boy, eh? He wasn't your pal, guy. Oh, I still can't actually go into the clinic. So let's go somewhere else. Oh, there she is. What's up is gangsteries?
I'll deal with you later.
Oh, come on, enough of that now.
First of all, here's your panties back.
Ugh.
You'll pull Godfathers out of them? Okay, that would be impressive. That sounds dangerous.
Thank you.
Okay, still no right. Oh, looks like we can talk to Wocky now, potentially. He has such a way with words. OG time, all the time, represent! Yeah, you! God, he's terribly annoying. Ouch. Harsh, bro. Guess I gotta go see right now? Maybe? No. Oh, is that all I had to do? I just had to turn the screen? Well, I've presented pretty much everything I can to this kid, so nothing else we can do with him right now. Maybe I can do something at the park now. Oh! Oh. It's Gavin. Hello, Mr. Prosecutor. Thank you. Auf Wiedersehen! And he's gone. Gloomy skies. Let's hit the park so that Ema can hit us with snackoos. She took the tarp off. Hello, Ema. I'm surprised she failed the test. Like, you would have thought she would have been a shoo-in. A prosecutor should be cool of wit and furrowed of brow. Gavin was the one who stripped Wright of his badge. Oh. Yikes. We should be back. Aw, she thinks we're friends. Let's give it a go. Of course I filled the hole. I'm pretty good at filling holes. Hey, wait a minute. Okay, so this should be Stickler's. Yep. Yeah, they sure do. Although with Wocky, he looked like he had gum stuck to his shoe. That's what it looked like to me. Thank you. Well, we know what this belongs to. Okay, guess she's got nothing else to say to us. Okay, so finally, we can get into that damn clinic. Okay, so these slippers definitely came from here. And those are noodle bowls? They look like noodle bowls. You know, it's weird that he's calling them sandals when they're really just women's high heel shoes. These are sandals. Ah, yeah, we could, Spook. Here we go again. Oh shit, this place has been ransacked. Thank you. There we go. Nurse Alita Tiala. Ooh. Well, that's not good. I don't know, Eldoon disappeared. A forging attorney. Things are starting to piece together here. Don't spook. Please don't. I wonder too, Apollo. So, these definitely belong to Alita, and she also wore those slippers which were found in the trash can near the crime scene. Miko, that is not what it was about, and you know it. Don't you dare take that out of context. I'm not a degenerate, like some people here. Okay, so we're getting somewhere. Really? Just like that? Just straight to into a marriage proposal? Very suspicious. Up. Oh, if only Q were here. So he meets this woman who's a nurse at the clinic, and she suddenly says she wants to marry him, just like that. Something's not adding up. Hey, looks like Eldoon's back. ABD? All but dead. Oh. Oh! Okay, so it's not his real hair. It's just part of the outfit. Ugh, he looks weird without it. Yeah, he sure does. So it he would have been too at risk to remove the bullet because it would have probably nicked something and just kill him on the spot. Snug as a bug there next to the aorta, which is connected to the heart. Surrounded by blood vessels. 2 millimeters either side and there'd be some serious bleeding going on there. Yeah, I can see that. Well, Trucy, think you can pull it off? Damn. She read my mind. With the heart pumping and lungs working, the bullet's on the move. Half a year tops. Jesus. So he could drop dead any day now. Thank you. Only a matter of time before his heart hemorrhages and he drops cold. Damn. That's depressing. You're up against real evil. Don't matter if you're weak or strong, it'll take you all the same. What was she thinking indeed? Well, things are definitely coming together. I mean, think of it from his perspective. He's a back alley doc working for the mob. What would happen? What do you think would happen to him if he suddenly told the mob boss, "I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do for your son, he's going to die." Yeah. Hey there, right? Hear that, right? She wants a mom. You gotta be more than a hobo, right? Gotta give her a mom. Yeah, you do that there, Trucy. I'll be very impressed. His bee trove? What? Too many brides these days can't even weave baskets blindfolded underwater. What a bizarre thing to say. Okay, let's hear her out. Or ballistic markings. Switchblade made out of chewing gum and a chocolate gravestone? Wow. Okay, are we going for it? I think we are. Oh, she didn't like that. Ooh. She sure did. Wow, she started showing her true colors already. Well, that was a fun way to get a penalty. It probably was the other shoe. Yeah, there we go. I mean, I guess they wouldn't know. I mean, we know that the toe prints match between the shoe and the slipper. And the slippers say Meraktis on it, so I thought that was going to be the case. But the shoe was on the other foot there. Yeah, I mean, like I said before, Gavin is basically a reformed Edgeworth. That's plain and simple, that's what he is. No, I don't think it's the... No, it's not the line. It's the Dark Secrets line. I'm just looking at my evidence for clues. So, I think I need to present one of these items from the safe. Because it's pretty safe to assume that she's the one that broke into the office looking for something. It's just, I don't think it can be the chart again, since I just presented it not too long ago. But it makes the most sense that this is what she'd want to get out of the safe. Well, let's give it a try. Objection! Oh, well, there we go. I'm just always iffy about presenting the same evidence in such a short time span. We got a reaction. Gotta bring her to the bracelet realm. Use your special eyes, Apollo. My bread! Gotcha! Gotcha! Okay, we got her. Very cool. Seems that way, Gavin. Well, let's give it a try.
Objection!
Oh, or not. Yeah, maybe. Guess I might as well save just to be safe. Okay, so it's from the same gun. Thank you. Oh, he didn't like hearing that. Accuse. Your honesty is like a breath of foul air, Fraulein. That's wackyo. No. Actually, yeah, that's a good point. If the safe was open and the bullet was in there, why didn't she take it? It's clear you're not a very good fiancé. Yeah, I bet she can't weave baskets blindfolded underwater. Get a load of this chick. Yeah, we already know that he was on the opposite side. But we also had his footprint there, and that proves that that's where he was standing. I know where this is going, but I'm pretty sure I know where it was. Oh well, game over. Now, I said the front because that's where the footprint where the footprint was found. I mean, it can't be around here. Because if she was here, then she'd be in plain sight. The footprint, Oh, wait. It's the card itself. I completely forgot that there was a bullet hole found inside of the cart. I'm surprised it took him this long to bring up that other toe print. I got it. Take that! All these bowls were found in the clinic. Thank you. Perceive the truth, huh? Gotcha!
Thank you.
You've got a cut on your neck, don't you? Oh, wasn't it? Oh, it's not a cut. It's a mark of strangulation. Weird bird. That's a pretty tame breakdown, though. Tried to strangle her with the cord. Yeah, that's a terrifying shot. Oh, Gavin? This party's getting crazy. Let's rock. Oh, he was probably trying to dispose of the body, thinking she was dead. That makes a lot of sense. See, this line right here is why I call him a reformed Edgeworth. Just like him, he only wants to know the truth. He would have grabbed the noodle stand next, right? And taken out all the bowls to put the quote-unquote body? That's the only thing that really makes sense from my evidence. Crazy talk, you're all crazy. Well, it's pretty obvious. Just dump it in the river. That's when he gets the bullet in the right temple, from inside the cart. Thank you. Yeah, he got hit by a car. Apparently he was sent flying and his head bashed the back of a lamppost. And he walked away with only like a twisted ankle. Despite the fact he flew into a head first into a street lamp. That's true, he did fall off a cliff. Well, nobody else could have stolen the stand. They'd have no reason to. You can't say the car didn't run. Oh, wait! Right! Because, remember what Gavin was saying. It always comes back to the Trucy's panties. Yeah. Even the truth. Yep, because these were stuffed into the exhaust pipe. Oh, looks like she's given up. I like how he just played for us, so he's like, yeah, you win. So you blew his brains out. It was kind of offhandedly mentioned that there was a bullet hole inside the stand. It was mentioned once, and it was never mentioned again. Which is interesting. And that's why at first I thought... it was gonna be from the side of the cart, because that's where her footprint was. I completely forgot about the bullet hole. What? You are screwed up, girl. You believed in us to get our client guilty? Wow. What a bitch. Also, that little bit of information he just gave there. Again, that was something that was kind of offhandedly mentioned, and it's nowhere in your court record. So, if you didn't remember what Gavin said about the exhaust pipe, you kind of had to guess there. Hooray! You found one? Hey! I can finally see his eyes. Tiny little eyes. God damn, Wocky. Ha ha ha. I like to bore without the puppy dog eyes. There he goes. Nice. Some nice hot salty noodles that may or may not have bird poop in it from the water he used. So that is the end of case 2. So I know this next case is not as good as the previous two. Because it's back... Do you remember in case 5 how many times we had to... Let's go back to that video! Well, we're about to have deja vu again. Okay, so I'm done for now. Goodbye.